The United Nations General Assembly continues its diplomatic struggle concerning the post-war military and political situation in the Middle East. Resolutions are put to the vote by the world body following 14 days of discussion and debate. The Soviet Union suffers a significant defeat when the UN rejects Russia's resolution asking for condemnation of Israel as the aggressor in the Arab-Israeli war, votes on aid to civilian war victims and the voiding of Israel's Jerusalem annexation were passed. Sporadic fighting continues to erupt along the Suez Canal. Arab and Israeli forces exchange mortar and machine gun fire across the canal, breaking the temporary truce. Each side blames the other for starting a three-day outbreak of shooting. Israel claims they lost one soldier with 19 wounded, while also reporting the downing of an Egyptian MiG jet over the Gulf of Suez. Cairo said none of its planes were involved. A nervous ceasefire remains in effect in the Middle East, but bitterness and hostility on both sides remain a constant threat to permanent peace. Allenby Bridge at the Jordan River, scene of the first mutual exchange of prisoners between Israel and its Arab neighbor, Jordan. Two Israeli pilots, shot down over Iraq during the Six-Day War, crossed the patched-up bridge destroyed by artillery and airstrikes. The Red Cross supervised the exchange. ...24 Jordanian troops captured by the Israelis returned to their homeland. The group includes 17 officers ranking up to colonel and three Iraqi consular officials. The wounded and injured are helped or carried over the crossing point. 25 Jordanians still hospitalized will be released soon, completing the exchange. Pope Paul VI presides at solemn ceremonies at the Vatican, where 24 new cardinals from four continents are proclaimed. The new princes of the church swell the ranks of the Sacred College to a record 118. The entire ceremony is streamlined, shortened in keeping with the current church trend toward greater simplicity and elimination of medieval pomp and splendor. Among the new cardinals are four Americans: Brennan, Dean of the Sacred Roman Rota, Cody of Chicago, Kroll of Philadelphia, and O'Boyle of Washington. The pontiff calls for a revitalization of the office of cardinal in the church and urges modern use of the rank. Parliament Hill in Ottawa, where Britain's Queen Elizabeth and Prince Philip attend a mammoth outdoor party, symbolic of Canada's 100th birthday. Earlier, the Queen addressed Parliament in both English and French, urging national unity. A crowd of 30,000, mostly children, with special guests, and the royal couple was the center of all attention. Using a knife her father, King George VI, used 28 years ago in Ottawa, the Queen makes a determined struggle of cutting into the 20-foot-high, one-ton mountain of confection. The hostility shown the Queen in her Canadian tour 3 years ago is absent, and the week-long visit is a success.